The best way to have an organized site is to have sitemaps. The two main types of sitemaps are HTML sitemaps and XML sitemaps. A HTML sitemap is for your website users. This allows for your website users to quickly find content on your website. An XML sitemap is a sitemap for the search engines, and you can easily tell them what the pages on your website is about. This helps them to crawl your web pages a lot quicker. If you don't currently have an XML sitemap, you can go to xml-sitemap.com and you can download one there and upload it to your website. Once you have your XML sitemap, you can literally give it to the search engines. This helps them to crawl your website a lot quicker, and you can do this by using tools. The first tool is the Google Search Console tool. I'm going to be showing you how to use it. It's important to remember that you must sign up for an account with Google Search Console. If you have a Gmail account, then this sign-up process is a lot easier. This is the page that you're going to see when signing up for a Google Search Console account, and then you want to click Start Now. Once you have registered for an account, you will actually need to verify that the website you have submitted is your own website. You will see this page here where it shows you details of how to exactly verify your site. If you face any verification issues, you can contact your developer who can help you out with this process. If you don't have a developer, then I suggest you contact your hosting company and they should provide you information on how you can quickly do this. Alternatively, if you're using a website provider such as Wix or Weebly, then they should have information on their site on how you can quickly verify your site with Google Search Console. This is how it will look when your Google Search Console account has been set up. Now, there's no data in this particular site because I am just using this as a way of instructing you. However, you will see data in here when you actually plug your website in to the Google Search Console. It's important to note that when you sign up for a Google Search Console account, you will get an email notification telling you of all of the important steps that you need to take in order to register and sign up for Google Search Console appropriately. You want to make sure you go through all of those steps so that Google are not missing any information. Just quickly, some of the most important ones are to make sure you have all of your website variations, and you can add your variations by coming up to here, clicking on here, and add a property. These properties or variations are different ways people can actually find your website. As you can see here, the first variation has http://psmentoring.com, and the second one is exactly the same thing, but without the www dot. I may also have https://mywebsite.com. And if you have one of those sites, you want to add that property as well, because Google sees these as different sites. You can also use a Google Search Console to see how your website is performing in search. And you can go onto this performance tab here, and this will show you how many times your site is showing up in search and generally how well you're performing. The most important aspect of your Google Search Console is your sitemap. You can click sitemap here, and this shows you how to exactly submit your sitemap to Google. Similar to the Google Search Console, there is a tool that you can use to submit your sitemap to Bing and Yahoo. As you may know, Bing and Yahoo are also major search engines, so you want to capitalize on the traffic that they can potentially send to your website. The sign-up process to Bing Webmaster Tools is very similar to that of Google Search Console. However, there are a few things that I want to point out, and that is when you submit your sitemap, you need to add it here. And also, when you're going through this variation process, you want to make sure that all of these boxes are checked. When you submit your site to Google or to Bing Webmaster Tools, you will actually get notified via email if these sites have any issues indexing your website. You want to make sure that you give them permission to notify you of any issues. That is why it's important to go through that step in Bing Webmaster Tools, but with Google, it's automatically done for you. Lastly, ensure that when you register for these accounts, you're registering with an email that you're checking often. So if there is a crawling issue on your site, you can actually get notified and you don't miss that email.